For the best advice and techniques to run a successful, purpose-driven coaching and consulting business, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel and press the notification bell so you can get notified every week when I post a new video. Everyone, my name is Melissa Hughes, and I'm so excited to be here with you today. Today is the first of 5 masterclasses, and I'm telling you, this is for the giants in the world. And yes, I will go deep. I will share with you what the heck does that mean when I say that. And we're going to focus today on the 3 techniques, the secret techniques to awaken your inner giant, because we got to start at the beginning, all right? And so what I want to set as far as what we're going to cover today is, what does it even mean to be a giant? And how do you find the one you have within? And for some of us, we already know what that means, or just kind of, okay, I feel like I know what it means. And for some of y'all, you're like, well, can you break it down as to what you're talking about? So we're going to do that. All right. And then I want to share with you the 3 secret techniques to listen to your inner giant and help you break through, because society doesn't always teach this, right? So when you're a giant, there's certain things that you come with, and we actually have to get tooled up to really be the highest version of ourselves. And so we're going to talk about what those things are today, and then how this is going to really support you as you are living your life and rocking it out in your business, okay? Whether it be your career, your life, and your business, these things that we're going to talk about, these techniques will absolutely support you. So this is my promise to you, that at the end of the training, you'll know what it takes to free your inner giant, and you'll have the tools needed to free it. All right, so let's go forward, all right? So today, this is what I want to make sure that you have with you. And also, I want to make sure that I just laid out there as to what I mean when I'm talking about giants, all right? Because we do need to make sure we're on the same page. And if y'all know me as Melissa Hughes, you know that I am all about, I teach giants, I coach giants. I've been doing it for over 20 years. So when I say giant, I mean folks that are God celebrating. Now, I do say God. My nickname for God is Boss of All Bosses, because that's where our whole creation comes from. And some people use other words, and that's fine. I'm not caught up in that. But what I do believe is, when we are giants, it's always bigger than us. So what would behoove us is to lean into the creation of who we are, and who in the world created us, or what in the world created us. Because when we do that, then we're able to rise above a lot of challenges, a lot of obstacles. And we have the correct mindset when we know we're fully supported, when we are being the giant that we are. So that's why I have that at the top. The other part of being a giant is being integrity driven, because when you are in alignment with yourself, when you can speak your words and whatever it is, you might as well cash it in, because your integrity is so tight and so in alignment with yourself, with the people that you're here to serve, with your community, and it all starts with yourself, then you are unstoppable. Authority in your gifts and genius. Giants are multi-talented, multi-experienced. There's really no one-trick pony when it comes to being a giant. And that is actually the pluses, the pros and cons of being a giant, because there's not a lot of places we can go where people can see all of us and be able to celebrate all of us. And actually, most places we go, then we're actually kind of having to dim our light just so that everybody's comfortable. But that is not what I'm an advocate for. And so I'm just here to remind you, this is what it is to be a giant. This is what it is to be who you are. And also, non-negotiable in your servant leadership. Meaning that you have such a huge capacity, you are that powerful, that you could actually hold the space for others as well as holding the space for yourself in your growth, in overcoming, in celebrating. However, sometimes as giants, we kind of have it twisted in that we make sure that everybody's okay and we put ourselves the bottom of the list. And actually, I don't really have a problem with you being on the bottom as long as you're on the list. But as giants, we sometimes forget that, you know, we don't even put ourselves on the list as to when we're taking care of everybody else. So we are non-negotiable in our spirit of leadership, servant leadership. Another thing that makes giants giants is that we get to trust in our intuition. We get to trust ourselves. We're here for a reason. We're here for a purpose. And there's a lot of things that can go against the grain of messaging and support when it comes to being a giant. I'm just going to let you know right now. And I hope that y'all did get my warning. I'm just going to share with you, because I do have 20 years of experience in doing this, in coaching giants and serving giants and serving them, being able to be the strongest, most awesome version of themselves when they're serving the world. So I'm really not going to hold a lot back, because it is what it is. It's not here to be right or wrong, but oftentimes the worst thing we can do as giants is not trust ourselves. the worst thing we can do is to listen to everybody else define us as to who we are, what we should be doing, what's possible, what's not possible. And that will always make sure that we never grow, we never stand, we never thrive. And the worst thing that it does, it doesn't allow us to serve the people that we were uniquely designed and delivered to serve. So therefore, there's a part of the population, there's a part of humanity that doesn't even get what they need because that giant didn't wake up. That giant was succumbing to the other things around that did not support or celebrate him or her. The other thing is, giants stand for systematic and sustainable solutions and success. All right, because we know how hard it is to be acknowledged, to be celebrated, to be strengthened the way that we need to be strengthened, that when we get something good, we are all in unapologetically. Because once you understand what it is to be a giant and to stand as a giant, you really, nothing less than that feels good anymore. And let's just say you haven't really pulled off standing as the full giant that you are. You get very uncomfortable when it's mediocre. You get very uncomfortable when you're in a space that you don't even fit in because it's too small for you. I hope y'all can relate to what I'm saying because it is so real as giants. And all giants go through this at some point in time and another. So giants, like I said, are multi-talented. We have the capacity to serve deeper and wider than that when we're fully equipped. All right. And so I say sometimes to some of my folks that, you know, we can actually be born to be world-class brain surgeons, but I don't need you giants operating on me at age 5. Like, I need you to take your amazingness, your destiny, and get tooled up, get equipped up, know how to handle all this power that you were born with in order for you to truly be all that you can be in life. And it's very critical. So what giants do? Giants know their sole purpose and are ready to serve, all right? The beautiful thing about that is when you know why you're on this earth, there's really not too much anyone can tell you to discourage you from staying the path. Giants allow themselves to give from their overflow. Now, mind you, I'm telling you this based on after giants go through the appropriate tools, they get equipped up and they understand their mindset and they're really holding on their cloak. They're really stepping into who they are unapologetically. So they learn that, you know, everybody wins if you put your mask on. You know, when they tell you in the airplane, you know, put that mask on, that ear, you got to get your oxygen first before you go out there trying to save everybody. Because other than that, it will not work. So when you're a giant, you start learning what that looks like. And furthermore, it really, you start seeing for yourself that when you're okay, so many more people are okay. When you are fine and you're taken care of and you're whole, man, like your destiny and who you're there to serve, it's a done deal. Also, you don't have to be less or play small. When you're playing small, nobody wins. Nobody wins whatsoever, but sometimes we're so conditioned to believe that that's the only way to exist so that everybody is happy that we lose the point altogether. And when I'm saying this, I'm really not trying to be Pollyanna. I'm not trying to be the ultimate optimist. Everything that I'm saying here, this is a journey to get here. No one's born with just knowing this stuff. And you might be born with knowing it. Let's just say you were. But life actually has a way of, you have an opportunity to unlearn it. You have an opportunity to deconstruct what you thought you already knew and have to find your way back again. Also, you surround yourself and then you find out that there's no need to dim your light because when you dim your light, no one can find you. So if you're a giant, first of all, if you have a dim light, you still can't hide because you're a giant. You just look off balance. You lose your confidence. You lose your swagger. You lose the essence of who you be. A lot of times we don't give credit to our own light and how important it is. So we're here doing, you know, and like fitting in, trying to fit in with everybody else, but we're not being in our strength, being in our energy, being in our talents, being in our gifts, and really shining our light so it gives other people permission to shine theirs. And that's a tragedy. Giants also surround themselves with people who are willing to let them shine. And actually, I thought I had edited this already because no one needs to let you shine. You need to surround yourself with people that see you and celebrate you. That's it. No one needs permission to shine because the light's already yours and it's not on the table for debate. And also, as a giant, you have the grace to for yourself, so you also have the grace to encourage others to shine their light as well. So you want to recognize what love looks like and feels like as a giant. Because when you understand that you're plugged into your creator, you know, and I'll say God, because that's what it is for me, but I don't really have a problem with what you call your creator. My point is this, when you know that you have backup all the time, that is like love. That is like something that you can't shake. It's always there for you. There's always support. It's always kind. It's not steeped in judgment and no disrespect or any of that stuff. It is gentle. It is kind. It is encouraging. That's what love looks like. And when you have that and you know you feel that every day, every second of the day, then you know that all is well. Okay. So are you a giant or do you have a sleeping one inside of you? I just explained what it is. And so what I wanted to start off with explaining it, because there might be some parts of what I say that you totally see yourself in that. And there might be some parts that you're like, well, okay, 2 out of 5 ain't bad or something like that. But you have an inkling that this exists for you as well. I actually don't believe in accidents. So if you're on this call, there is something that's already telling you to spend your quality time in between your meetings, in between what you have going on, to take time to talk about this conversation, to be in this conversation. So just the signs that you might have a sleeping giant inside of you. You feel that you have a higher purpose to serve, and you know the world needs your gift. Even if you're not really sure what to do about it or who they are, you know it. And what that is that's that inner voice inside of you. That's what we call intuition. Okay. That's what we call the spirit. You know, you're born with support, and support will continually whisper in your ear, whisper to your soul, and always remind you, it doesn't matter how high on the hog you are outside of your purpose or how deep in the trenches you are outside of your purpose. It doesn't go away. It will bug you. Okay. And it's always kind. It's always wonderful. And it's very consistent, and it's not going to shout at you, but it'll let you know that you have a purpose. And it'll keep you, it'll let you know, if you're on it or not. The further you are away from it is the more it feels like this fire in your belly. And the further you're in alignment with it, it feels like you're in alignment and you feel love and things really open up. And even when you are in your purpose and you have a level of opposition, whether it be physical or spiritual, you still have the power of being in alignment really supports you through even those times. So you are also ready to do the work. You might be afraid or confused, but you're ready. It's like ready to jump in, you know, not knowing how to, not being sure-footed. Because when you are a giant, you are multi-talented. So someone can maybe teach you how to do one part of who you are as a giant or this other part of you as a giant, but there are really not a lot of people that can embrace all of you as a giant and really support you. So you have that clarity. So you're less afraid and you are more confident. Oftentimes when we go to education, we go to colleges, universities, they teach us, we have a book, you know, we know, okay, this is how we do this. This is how I become a teacher. This is how I become a doctor. This is how I become like whatever this profession is. However, they don't speak to everything. They just give you the technical tools to do it. All right. And when we're used to getting those kind of blueprints, or even if we're in corporate America, we pretty much know like standard operating procedure or the culture of the organization. We figure it out. We're quick learners. That's okay. We got that down. But when you're looking to step into you and partner with a creation that is you and what you're here to do on this earth, that no one on this earth can define for you, it really ends up being like, oh my gosh, you know, we're used to being very competent. But when we don't have that mapped out in a way that really resonates with our soul, resonates with our purpose, it gets confusing. And we do get afraid. And we sometimes take it as, oh, I can't do that. Let me stick with my good paying job because that right there is too much for me. I don't have my certainty. I don't know how to make that work. So let me play it safe. I hope that y'all can understand where I'm coming from. This is just a clue that you might have a sleeping giant inside of you. Or you want to set these big goals, but sometimes you question yourself and your capabilities. So it's like, why did this goal even come to you in the first place? You know, if these goals were not meant for you to accomplish, why are they knocking on your door? But based on how big they are, and if you don't have the appropriate support, it does make it scary. It really does. So I don't blame you for it, but that's kind of how you know, like, you're not given these big goals if you're not a giant. You're given big goals because you are deemed as capable, and it is possible for you to accomplish them if you're willing to go down the path, if you're willing to choose powerfully that you're all in. The other thing is you're willing to be held accountable and part of an intimate community, because giants are not loners. You know, when you're small or you're by yourself, you're never as strong as if you're with other giants, okay? It doesn't mean that other giants are taking over your destiny, your swim lane, your sole purpose. But energetically, people thrive. Giants thrive when they're amongst other giants. When you're amongst and you're in a community that says celebrates you, you celebrate them, and that energy keeps on going and growing, that only supports you in being big in your gianthood, okay? And then you're ready to share your wins and your fall forwards, because giants can be vulnerable. You know, you don't get the big wins if you can't handle the small wins. You don't get the big wins if you don't fall. You know, if any giants were to believe that they can get to a multi-million dollar business, that they can get to see all the grandchildren, or they get to have all, they can get to be the height of their height of the career, you best believe as a giant, you were in training the whole time. And training does not always feel good. However, when you have the appropriate training when it comes to mindset for a giant, then you're able to take it in stride, as opposed to thinking, oh, that means I'm not meant to move forward. Oh, that means I'm not good enough. Oh, that means. We don't put extra meaning to it. It's part of the training. So we are able to embrace that. And you know there's abundance waiting for you, although it might feel unattainable. It might feel that way because you might not have seen it like that before, or you just don't know how to get there, or people have already told you, oh, I wouldn't do that if I were you. That's crazy. So these are the things that when you have these things inside of you, these are indicators that you might very well have a sleeping giant inside of you. So those are just a few, there are more. So why is it sleeping? Like, why does this even happen? And I'm saying that, you know, when I said this is what a giant does and this is how you define a giant, I am saying that because even when you might be able to check off all those boxes, if you're a giant that's breathing and living, you're going to be growing. So every once in a while, the things that I just listed can come up in your life again. So these are the things. These are the things that can keep your inner giant asleep. The first thing is your past. Which is crazy, because if we think about it, your past has nothing to do with your future, like for real. However, we get influenced. You know, what you went through might be holding you down, it might be keeping you stuck. And when giants are not able to see that this was all in alignment with what you were getting trained on for the future, it's hard, it's heavy. Some of us have very heavy stories, have very heavy experiences. I think everyone has. If you're a giant, there's a high likelihood you have gone through something challenging. Like, let me just be very clear with you. I don't care how phenomenal you look, how great you're put together. I don't care what your accomplishments and your achievements are. If you're a giant, you got some battle scars. Now, what's beautiful about it is what you do with it. But I want to let you know that we all do this, and that can cause us to sleep sometimes when we are going through what we're going through. If we had a tragedy, if we had a separation, if we had a divorce, if something just blindsided us, a betrayal, you know, lots of things can happen. But this is what can keep you asleep. Or what your friends and your family and your loved ones say about you. You know, it'd be different if it was a stranger. But sometimes we trust people. A lot of times, you know, you should be in situations where you can trust. And something might happen, and it's what someone said about you or to you that just cut through the core. And even though that was not you, in that moment, oh, that change of trajectory, that got you sleeping, just like, it just put you out. Or your beliefs about yourself that, you know, you might've been told, you might've tried something back in the day that you were so enthusiastic about, and it might've just toppled on you. And it doesn't matter how far back in the day is, it could be from a single digit to double digits, you know what I mean? But there can be things that you experience in life or ways that you learn behavior that really has you not seeing yourself as a giant. You tolerate things that you probably shouldn't be tolerating. You stay in conversations too long that really doesn't serve your soul or others. So these are things that can limit you. And when you're limiting your beliefs, other things will find you that don't really serve you. When you expand your beliefs, then you're too busy on your purpose. You're too busy on your mission. They can't get to you as fast. But limiting our beliefs as to what we're capable of or what other people are capable of can keep us very small. And that's what has giants sleeping. Also, what you tell yourself about where you came from, all right? I can tell you it's irrelevant where you came from. Sometimes it's where you came from that makes you the tallest giant, the best for the job of what you were given. But when we're in the different conversation and we're kind of listening to our past, we might make where we came from a limiter. we might say, oh, well, you know, well, I came from here. I came from, you know, the inner city, or I came from a less advantaged family. Like it, you know, it goes as gambit. Or you might have come from a rich family, but you felt like you didn't get any love or any attention, or your parents were never around because they were working all the time, or they had their own things going on, so they didn't have time for you. It can be anything. You pick it. I've been doing this for 20 years. There's a whole plethora of things that you can think about when it comes to your past that might have you sleeping because it's now in control of your future. Okay, because that's just how you're experiencing life right now. Or it can be your present. It could be like, yeah, okay, forget the past, but right now I'm dealing with this. So that can keep a giant sleeping too. You can look at your circumstance and be so caught up in right now that you can't see that you have the power to either change that or you have the power to create your future, period, regardless of where you're standing. So it's what are you telling yourself in the moment, in this very present moment? Are you celebrating yourself? Are you giving yourself encouragement? Are you speaking down to yourself? Are you calling yourself names? Are you honoring yourself? What are you doing? I often say that, you know, what's in your bank account is not the value of what your soul is. So whether it's multi-millions or whether it's negative 50, it doesn't define how valuable you are as a person. So how are you speaking to yourself? What are you telling yourself? And also, you can be sleeping if you're giving so much you are having an empty cup. It's like how when you're pouring from an empty cup, things start breaking down. The integrity of the cup starts messing up. That can impact your health. It can impact your physical health. It can impact your mental health. It can impact how you feel about yourself. It can impact so many things. But yet, giants are so often conditioned to give, forget about replenishing, keep on giving. Because sometimes that's our strength that just kind of, we lead with that. But you have to be able to balance that out. So sometimes it's your present condition that can have you sleeping. Now, I'm going to give you the secret techniques to awaken your inner giant. Because you know what? We can look around today, this week, last week, on and on and on and on. And we can look at our children. We could look at our nieces and our nephews. And we could actually know that there's a future, but what does this future look like? And sometimes we can feel stuck. And sometimes we can feel like, you know, when you're a giant and you're awake, you could look at this and you'd be like, all right, bet. All right, let me just really bring in everything that I am. And let me just rock this out. Because I know when I'm okay, there's going to be multiples of people that are okay. If I'm serving in the highest version of myself. And then you can be asleep. You can be like, oh my gosh, this is like fear. It's closing in. What can I do? Who am I? And so I am here. I'm here to give this masterclass 5 times. We're going to be here meeting to really support and lean in and to share with you the techniques, things that you can consider. The beautiful thing is you have choice. So you can choose if you want to take it on or not. But I am here because I got to be here, y'all. This is my job. My job is to support the giants. So when the boss of all bosses says, hey, you need to do this, this is what I'm going to do. I don't even care. I'm like, all right, you know, I know you got me. So here I go. Press, you know, that whole deal. And so I'm not here to make anybody happy. I'm not here to make anybody sad. I'm here to just share with you that I encourage you to wake up. I encourage you. And I'm not just saying wake up if you're sleeping a bit. I'm also saying that I want to be a part of supporting you in doing that. Because sometimes it's not that we want to be sleeping, it's that we might not have the tools as a giant. So here's the number one thing. Identify what's holding you back. The reason I say that is sometimes we're just so busy in our doing, we don't have time to sit down and pontificate as to what's really holding us back. We're just out there, you know, mechanically. And so I want you to just make a list of all the things that's holding you back, whether it be professionally or personally. And it is 2020. It's like there's something magical about this year. And so I want you to do this assessment right now. You know, we have our goals and we start off really strong as far as, oh, wow, I'm so excited about this new year. I'm going to rock it out. And about 3 weeks in, stuff starts happening. It's like all that enthusiasm we had when we're, you know, doing the, you know, whatever those things are, blowing into those like little toy things and doing the champagne or high-fiving or giving people hugs in church or whatever, it kind of wears off. Well, I want to see I want you to take some time out for yourself because you deserve it. Make a list of all the things that are holding you back, both personally and professionally. What are these obstacles that could be getting in the way for you to just stay awake? Be awake and stay awake. And then answer the key questions to get unstuck, right? After you list them down, are you here to serve and make a difference, or would you rather spend time worrying about what people think and say about you? Now, this is interesting because I know as a young kid, my mom be like, don't worry about people, what people think or say about you. But you know what, honestly, I don't care what age you are. Sometimes we're a little susceptible to caring about what other people think. Some of us aren't, but there's a lot more of us that are than aren't. So how is that impacting you today? And I'm happy if you're like, oh, that does not impact me at all. And that's great. But if it is, give yourself some grace and let's figure out what that's all about. Also, what fears are keeping you stuck in your business right now? You know, do you think you can do it? Is the cash flow low? Did you lose a big account, you know, or are you just not sure? Did you just lose your confidence? You don't have a plan. You don't have the clarity. Or are you trying to transition from corporate to, you know, you have the golden handcuffs and now you're trying to get over to here, but look, you got to create those golden handcuffs over there. No, you have to create the golden. It doesn't have to be handcuffs. So what is it? Is it a lack of a plan? What's keeping you stuck? What's having you cycling over and over, going back to the same place all the time? What do you need to learn that is outside of your comfort zone that can help you move forward in your business and overcome your fears? Oftentimes, as a giant, we have to be used to living outside our comfort zone. That's just where the magic is. It's when you don't know what you don't know. And you're willing, but you're following your intuition. You know this is the right direction. Not that it has any certainty around it. When you're living a large life that is based on thriving, there's no like exact playbook. Part of the thriving is that you're leaning into the creation of what is possible for you. And when it's possible for you, it's possible for those around you that you're here to serve. But you need to be whole in that and intact. So what does that look like for you? And what does 100% all in look like in your business and in your life? Because I'm going to tell you, giants, we get away with a lot of stuff because we're oftentimes so competent that we get credit that we don't even need to get credit doing. Because it's like for us, that was our 40%. And everybody thinks it's so fabulous. So we get to stay small because we're not really accountable. But when you know that there's more that you can provide, when you know that, like it's in you that you know that you can do more about that. You know, you might have your business and you're like, oh, I called a few people today, 3 people this week, 4 people last week. Oh, no, I didn't leave my house. Like, you know, that might sound great, but giants, that's not what it looks like. Like, if you're really there to serve the people that you are destined to serve, that's not what it looks like. You can do more. Now, you don't have to suffer or bleed out to do that, but you got to know and hold yourself to the standard of what's possible. But you just might not know because you're not hanging out with giants. So you might think that, oh, if I do any more, oh, everything's going to break down. Well, if you're in a conversation with a giant, you'll understand that, oh, you can get more done and do less at the same time. It won't be what you think it's going to be. So what does 100% all in look like for you? What does it look like for you in your life? You know, when you look at different parts of your life, you actually get the context clues, you know, that you go but so far and then you stop or you stall out. What does that look like? So I hope you're able to take that on. I don't care if you feel like you're the biggest giant now or not. It's always good to check in because as a giant, we have this amazing opportunity to grow and grow and grow in our calling, in our purpose, in our power, in our effectiveness. And with each level of growth, then there are things that come up. So no one's immune to being susceptible to falling asleep. Okay, let's just be clear. The other thing I want you to do is give yourself permission to shine. We don't do that enough. Give yourself permission to move forward powerfully. Like it's available for you. You don't have to get permission to do that, but you have to give yourself permission. Give yourself permission to make more money. I don't actually care if you've seen it before. Like that. Give yourself permission. Give yourself permission to create your enterprise, your empire. What does that look like for you? Be willing to start leaning into what is available to you and give yourself the opportunity to be all that you can be. And isn't this crazy? I'm saying give it to yourself. I'm also saying you don't need to wait on your husband to approve, your wife to approve, your mom to approve, your dad to approve. Oh, my cousin's holding me back. No, actually, none of that. It starts with you. You got to give yourself permission because you deserve it. And as far as we know, this is the breath that we have right now. So with the breath that you're breathing and the opportunities of life that's in front of you, why not? So when I say give yourself permission to shine, I'm saying give yourself permission to shine your brilliance. Shine what's inside of you. Shine when your knowledge, your expertise. But there's a way as giants that we can do that very freely. Sometimes we're limited when we are having to work for someone else. I will tell you, corporate America loves giants because we have so much to give and we're multi-talented. And the thing about it is it could work. It actually can work. If you're a giant and you're working for a company, your values are in alignment, you feel acknowledged, you feel like this is it for you, that you can do your divine assignment within these walls, fantastic. However, there's a lot of times when you're working for someone, they'll take everything that they need to hit their bottom line, but they don't really want to know about the personal part of you. They're not really interested in that part of shining. Like, they don't see that value. They just want you to stay focused right here. And that can be limiting for a giant, for a lot of giants. Honor your voice. Like, your voice is just as important as the other person's. Challenge is, as a giant, when we don't cultivate how we speak or understand how giants speak, then we're so powerful what we say, it actually kicks. It could actually be that brain surgeon at 5 years old. That's actually phenomenal, but they don't know how to use their tools yet. So with their energy being a giant and their words kind of being small, it can create a disruption. Not that there's anything awful, but you want to be able to train and groom yourself up as the giant that you are. Honor your voice, honor how you feel, be able to speak to that in a way that it lands, in a way that you get the results. You don't chop any people up, you know, and I'm saying, if you've encountered a giant that can cut with an eye or cut with a word, then, you know, that's fine because it's available to all giants. We could pounce somebody out in a heartbeat, but that's not really why we're here on this earth. That's not the value that we bring. So as a giant, when you're able to honor your voice and really support others in a way that is uplifting, including yourself, we all win. Invite others to shine. You don't want a lot of dim lights around you. Like, that's too much to hold up. So you shine and you invite others to shine because that really shows how much of a giant you are. When you're like not fazed by other people's brilliance and their smarts and what they're doing in the world, and that either just encourages you, it gives you energy to do what you're doing as an encouragement as well, we all win. So you want people that are shining around you. You don't want the cattiness. You don't want a lot of stuff people call it these days. You just don't want that. Haterism, none of that. It doesn't serve anybody. It just keeps you small. Never shrink to make others feel comfortable. Like, no. At the end of the day, you were gifted with life. You know, this is a gift. It's an honor to be here. So if you're a gift, why are you shrinking? Like, that's a disrespect. Might not think of it that way, but, you know, it's like if you're a parent and you invest all these things into your children and then they like make decisions that do not honor any of all this investment you've made in them, you're going to feel a certain kind of way. So, you know, there's no less circumstance. You are a gift. You deserve to be here. You deserve to be fully awake as a giant. And if others are not comfortable with that, you shine your light and you carry sunglasses so you can give that to them. But you at no time shrink to make others feel comfortable. And embrace all of who you are and all of who you're becoming. All of who you are, because this is a world of imperfection. There's nothing perfect about anybody, which is beautiful. But understand that we always have an opportunity to grow in being a giant. And as we're growing, be prepared for that. Embrace it. Don't find opportunities to knock yourself down, to speak negatively to yourself or those around you. Don't find those opportunities. Find those opportunities that when you fall down, man, I'm so glad that you took a chance. Oh yeah, that's pretty bad, but hey, let's get back up and do this thing. There are ways that we can talk and embrace all of who we are that doesn't diminish the courage that it takes to be a giant that's awake. And number three, you want to discover and live your soul purpose. Now, your soul purpose is already inside of you, so you don't have to go, you know, it's really there. You know, what the thing about it, though, is when we're not solidified and grounded in our soul purpose, then we do chase a lot of things because we're chasing stuff that's outside of us. Like someone told us, if we get the house and the white picket fence, my family's originally from Jamaica. So it's like, you know, there's an American dream, you know? And they said, you get the nice car, you get the good education, you get married, you have the children. And oh my gosh, that's like all external things. What about coming from your soul purpose and seeing how amazing you are and why you're here and why it's important and why some of your choices that you need to make are in alignment with making sure that you're whole and everybody around you is whole. So you got to be whole. And understand that when you're in your soul purpose, things do work out. So discovering your soul purpose is a journey. You know, at 5 years old, your purpose is totally different than at 25 and 55 years old. So there's a beautiful thing about discovering your soul purpose in the journey, because you get like promotions, like they're like, you get a divine assignment, you do that pretty good, and then it shifts. So then you get a universal promotion, then you get another divine assignment. So it's great to discover what that looks like. It's an amazing ride. Give yourself permission to do that. And your soul purpose is inspired. Not only does it like not go away, it actually is when you're in the belly of it, when you're in alignment with your soul purpose, you have more energy. Like you want to do it. You're invigorated. You get up in the morning. You don't feel like there's lead on your legs. I don't know if y'all ever been someplace or reported to a workplace and it's like, oh, like every day was a Monday and it felt like cement was on your feet. That is not your soul purpose. You are not inspired. So your soul purpose does inspire you. And when I say inspire, I don't mean it's going to be easy all the time. You know, some of y'all divine assignments are pretty hefty and it's okay. But you're also very inspired when you're in it and you're doing it and you see the fruits of it and you're feeling that, wow, like you're feeling the love that comes with that. And you're able to leverage all your gifts and your talents and even your experiences, your education, your training. There's nothing that you need to leave behind. I meet giants every day. And because of how society is like, oh, you're this box. You're this box, you know, and we're happy that we're this box because it's a pretty nice box. But the thing is that there's no box. Like, you actually have these other things. Don't throw away these things based on where you are. If you bring all of who you are to the circumstances you're in, oh, that's a bad mama jamma. That's a real sexy giant when you're living in your soul purpose. I meet people every day. They're so qualified. They have degrees or they have experiences that are phenomenal. And then we're talking and they're like, oh yeah, I served in the military. Really? Like, we're just now talking about that? Or I won this award of National Fitness Foundation, whatever. Like, it's just like stuff just pours out. And as a giant, we forget sometimes we have some fabulous things that make us unique and we just take it for granted. And you know, it's okay. I'm not saying be braggadocious, but I'm saying that like, these are all these tools that are in your toolkit. So when you were assigned and this was your sole purpose, don't forget all these tools. Some of them feel random at the time. But I'm telling you, don't forget them. Just keep your bag nearby because someone's going to enter in your life that's uniquely for you to serve. And it's that odd tool that you just didn't even think about that supports you in taking a stand for them. And that's how we all win. So leverage all of it. I don't care if anybody said it wasn't important. It's important. Don't worry about that. And your sole purpose is love. Just imagine living your life in pure love. So that even when harm comes your way, or even when more love comes your way, you can actually receive it. And it's something that is like, by all purposes, it was kind of bad, you know, felt bad. You can find your love through it. Love can find you through it. The soul purpose can support you in staying in the pocket of love. Even when you're happy or you're sad, when you have love, it still will reign over that, right? Like, it's still, love is stronger than happiness. It's a soul thing. And your soul purpose is bigger than you. You're here and you're like a messenger of what you're to do, which means that you're responsible for it, but you got equipment. You got backup. It's bigger than you. If your soul purpose is only counting on what you can do in that 24-hour time period, hey, I wouldn't be here with you today. I know that much. But neither would most of the giants that I'm serving. They wouldn't either. And neither would you. You know who you are. You know that it's bigger than you. And it's a really good feeling, because what happens is, if you know it's bigger than you, then you don't choose to stay stuck. You say, okay, I'm stuck, so where do I go next? Because it's bigger than you. You're going to get direction. And I'm just hoping that that serves you, because what happens oftentimes as giants is that we're so competent. We are like, we know how to do a lot of stuff. And we get this soul purpose and this divine assignment, and we're like, all right, God, I got it. I'll be back. I got this. And like, we forget that, like, don't do that. Like, what are you doing? Like, no, you bring your creator with you. It's bigger than you. But we're so competent sometimes, we don't understand that no matter how competent and multi-talented we are, we're still small when it comes to fully living in our soul purpose, fully being awake and in our gianthood. So to live your soul purpose fully means to discover who you really are and to accept yourself as you really are. Okay? So once your inner giant is awake, your life will start to change drastically. And I'm not saying that, you know, people sleep and they wake up. But I want you to be awake more than asleep. And sometimes circumstances can like put us out in a coma sometimes. But I want to be here to remind you, that you don't have to stay asleep. You might need support. You might need tools. I gave you 3 things today, and I promise you, as a giant, sometimes you can hear things, you're like, yeah, is that it? You know, no, really. Trust me on this one. Raise your awareness, because when our awareness is raised, we can choose differently. We can choose powerfully. If we don't take time to kind of check where we are with understanding the context of what it is to live your soul purpose, to understand the context of what it is to really shine, like for real, and to see what you're capable of doing in your shine. Sometimes we don't even know how bright our light really is, that it touches people that we see and we don't see. So give yourself that chance. And most importantly, giants, be willing to receive what that offers you. Sometimes we're so used to giving so much, we have a real problem with receiving. And so I don't want you to block your blessings or block your wins when you're on this path. So what happens is, whatever your mindset is, it can be very limiting. It can put you in a scarcity spot. What changes the game is really being able to stand in abundance. Abundance comes in many forms, okay? So I really am actually cautioning you that although most people think of abundance as money driven, it's really not. I have had a lot of clients and even colleagues that make a lot of money and they are miserable. So you want the kind of abundance that allows all of the areas of your life to be thriving. And money is a byproduct. But you want that kind of experience of life, as opposed to having the phenomenal job that you can pay the bills, but your soul's dying inside. Or you're like, now you're like working in something that is not your sole purpose. And you're like stuck like Chuck, because everybody's leaning on you because you're making all this money. And now you're stuck. Or you might just not have abundant relationships. We need connection. As humans, we need connection. You don't need everybody, but you need good people. You need to be willing to be open to that. So be open to the abundant life that you create, whether it be in your business, your career, yourself, when you're able to take on being a giant. It is, you know, it is possible you're a giant and have a mindset that keeps you small and keeps you in scarcity. And it's a rough life. It keeps you stuck as well. So for those of that don't know me, my name is Melissa Hughes. When I talk about being a giant, I do say, and you get those divine assignments, I've been on a world tour. Live Rich, Spread Wealth is the movement and the company that I created. And I didn't do it because I was just sitting around thinking about that. I did it because I felt like I was called to do it. And I said, what are you talking about, Willis? Like, you ain't talking to me. You ain't talking to me. Yeah, I was being talked to. And at the end of the day, I had to be like, well, first of all, where does this come from? Okay, my answer is yes, but look, I need help with this. And so as a result of being on a world tour, I have been sharing all over the world what it looks like to honor your soul purpose, to recognize it, identify, and monetize it. And so as a result of doing this, this is probably over 10 years, six to 10 years. But as a result of doing this, what I realized is that no matter what country that I've been to, whether I spoke the language or I had an interpreter because I didn't, this is a humanity thing. This is not a me thing. It's not just a you thing. We as giants need to be open to the possibility that there is work to be done and we don't have to die doing the work, but we also don't have to die with the work inside of us either. So I've been on a world tour. My company has 9 revenue streams. I have a team that is located all over the world because our clients are all over the world. And I say this stuff, I'm not saying it because I read it in a book. I said that even when I was through, and I have my business for over 20 years, even when I was in surgery or I was on bed rest because I was pregnant, you know, my business still thrived. Life adjusted for me because I stayed on point with my mission. And I'm definitely not going to tell you that it's been easy, but I do want to emphatically tell you that it's worth it. And whatever is in your heart, whatever is in your soul purpose, I just want to be here to encourage you to step into that, lean into it more. And the scariest parts of it, make it happen. Really do that. Because I will tell you that it doesn't matter. And this is such a funny picture. I don't know, my team puts the picture in there. And one time I sent this picture out to my list and the lady was like, well, you know, you could do something better with your makeup. And I was like, but I was in Panama with my family on Mother's Day weekend. I'm like, give me a break, lady. I'm not here to win a beauty contest. I'm here to just encourage you and let you know that, you know, there's a lot of great things that happen in the thriving in your soul purpose. And I'm not saying it's easy because you do have to groom yourself. You have to be okay with the ups and the downs, the fall forwards, the setbacks. It's okay. But I will tell you that in every fall forward, setback, up and down, it is a rich life to be in. It's a rich life to lean into why you are here and why you are designed to be who you are in the first place. It's a rich life to be able to leverage every setback that you have, learn from it, overcome it because you're a giant. That's how you got all these tools now because you overcame a lot of things and be able to make other people's lives easier. Give grace to others just because you shined your light. And when I say this, like I said, I don't take it for granted. I coach giants on a regular basis. And I'm letting you know, when you have folks that are educated, they're smart, and yet they might not believe in all that's possible. Well, they believe it now. You know, Azora, she's rocking it out. She's doubling her prices because she realized her worth. This lady was a bad mamma jamma walking in the door. Like, let me just be very clear. But there's nothing like a bad mamma jamma that knows her worth, that knows the impact, that knows why the world needs her and is up to answering the call. Profits come with that. You know, Maria, she's in Puerto Rico. You know, this is all over the world. It's not limited to your block or your city. It's whatever you choose to do. Some folks stay in the cities that they are in. Some folks have global businesses, but they're here to make a difference. But it takes a lot of courage to do that. And I'll tell you, as giants, we do have a lot going on, all right? Because that's just how it is. But when you want to make a difference, when you want to be an authenticity around what you're here for, then it's a game changer. So when giants are awake, you know your purpose and you're ready to serve. You're giving from your overflow. Abundance does come your way, but like there's always fine print, right? The fine print is you got to be willing to receive it. I have to say that because giants are very spiritual, right? Whether you're like totally into it or not, that we have the spirit within us. And based on some traditional grooming, we're told that like you can't really make money and be spiritual. You can't fear God and be rich. You know, that doesn't meet together. Some people do. Some people have been raised in that context of religion. And I'm not here to say if it's right or wrong, but I'm here to say as a giant, like no one can really afford for you out there broke trying to save the world. Like it doesn't work that way, right? Just think of this something as basic as having a good boss, like a good employer. And if you are really bringing in the customers and the customers are happy, everything's going great in the company, the profits are going up. Do you think like that, if you have a smart boss, they'd be like, hey, what can I do to support you? What do you need? You need some time off? Like they don't even care. It'd be an honor for them to make sure you're comfortable. But what if you had that good boss and you're like, no, I'm okay. I know I work 15 days in a row, haven't seen my family, but I'm up for the charge. I want to bring in those great clients. I want to make sure this company grows. Like seriously, like it's not even an expectation. You don't have to do that. Not in your soul purpose work. So yes, you can be totally spiritual. You can be very much a servant heart, a servant leader, wanting to give and do right by people and be high integrity. And you can make room for yourself as well. We actually prefer you do so because there's nothing like a resentful giant or a giant that feels martyr, that they are martyr. So also you want to trust yourself. Okay. Trust your intuition. When you know something is good for you, go for it. Go for it. Don't be like, oh, I got to think about it. Or let me consult with all these other people that are either not giants or they're putting limitations on your life anyway. So you want to surround yourself with people that are willing to accept and celebrate you, your shine, and encourage others to do so. and so much more. So today I just really wanted to come here and share with you what it means to be a giant and how to find the one you have within. And also, what are the three secret techniques to listen to your inner giant and help with the breakthrough, okay? Help your inner giant breakthrough, and how your business and your life will evolve once you've freed your inner giant. And I hope that this has served you. And as a giant, I want you to hear what I'm saying. The world needs you. The world needs the best version of you. The best version of you not only is an amazing way to serve others in your business, it's also a phenomenal way to understand what's available to you in your life. And being able to serve giants for the last 20 years, it has been phenomenal. When a giant is well equipped to do what you're to do, there's no stopping you. You're literally unstoppable, okay? And that's what I want. Oh, yes. So I want to encourage you, remember whose you are. Do the work because we need you. And you're not alone. So don't let anything in your life ever be in vain, because you are designed the way you are for a reason. And when you're able to serve people in a phenomenal way and get out of your way to receive the abundance that provides, then we all win. So take care. Thank you so much for being here today. And bye for now.